a real ghetto bitch. Woo! Real nigga shit. The fuck be a back bitch. Don't see the motherfucking Atlanta. I'm shitting on all these bitches. These bitches can't motherfucking touch me. Big
girls, AP,
all that shit. And that's just that on me.
Whole nother level, I've been in my bag and I keep getting better. I'm getting richer, that ass getting thicker, my diamonds, they keep getting wetter.
Hey guys, it's you girl, it's you girl, it's you girl, and I am back at it again with another video. So today, if you haven't noticed already, I'm gonna be doing a makeup tutorial on one of my lovely friends. She is so pretty. So we're just gonna jump right into it because clearly I already started. So right now I'm taking a eyebrow pencil. I don't really remember the name of it. I'm gonna put it in the description box, but basically it's a gel on the end and it's holding her brow still. And then I went in and I used my Duo lash glue to go ahead and seal those brows in from moving. This is just a new technique I wanted to try, which is really why I started, which is really why I decided to do someone's face for my channel, because I want to see if this technique would work. And let me just tell y'all, it did. So boom, that's a 10 out of 10. So yeah, right now I'm going in with the Duo lash glue and I'm going to be filling her brows in. So I went back in with this gel to seal them in, seal in the deal for real. So I don't know what it was, but like the brow was just literally like, it wasn't stiff, it wasn't crunchy. I don't know. It just, this technique really, really worked and I really suggest it. Depending on where your client is going, like she was going to have this face on all day. It was Easter, so I'm like, let me make sure I seal your brows in. They're not going to rub off. They're not going to smudge or anything, you know, with this technique. And I'm telling y'all, y'all will see the finished look. 10 out of 10. I'm sorry in advance. We were talking a lot through this video. So you're just going to see us like looking all shocked and like, for real, girl? We talked a lot in this video. So I started doing her brows, filling them in with the Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Pen in the shade Ebony. Her brows are pretty black, so I just wanted to go ahead and start the ends with that Ebony to give it some real realistic definition. And honestly, sealing them in made it way easier for me to fill her brows in, because it was almost like painting on a canvas. And then her brows were pretty like full from the beginning anyway, so it really wasn't much that I had to do. So I always start doing my brows on the end and then coming in, mostly depending on how the brows are. If it's somebody that does not have any brows at all, I would probably start doing their brows at the bottom at the beginning, just because it's easier for me to draw a line from start to end rather than end to start. I hope I made that make sense. But yeah, so I went in and just kind of like drew all on her brows to make them very full and very dark, because I wanted to give her a very, very seductive look, because of the eye look that I was going for. It was very subtle. So I wanted her brows to be very dramatic and full. Not so much natural, but more so like a full glam. Thank you. So, as you can see, I am concealing her brows right now. The color that I use is pretty, it pretty much matches her undertone. It is way lighter than her, but you do want to go up probably 2 to 3 shades when concealing under the brow, just because it gives you a good base, especially if you're doing a bright eyeshadow, which I am going to do. But yeah, I'm concealing under her brow. I'm using LA Pro Girl. I don't know the color. I'm gonna leave everything in the description box because I'm actually out of town right now and I don't have any of my products with me, and this video is pretty old. So yeah, I'm gonna leave the name for everything and add the description in later. But yeah, so I'm going ahead and I'm concealing her brows, and I'm gonna bring that concealer down onto her eyelids to start as a primer for the eyeshadow. I always recommend that you do this regardless of what, just because it blends better and you just want that natural seamless look as far as everything fading into each other. You don't want to leave any lines, and when you do this, this helps avoid all of that, and then this will also help bring light to your eyeshadow because the concealer will be sitting on here longer. So I went ahead and I used that same shade to conceal the top of her brows. I honestly, now looking back on this, I shouldn't have used the same shade because it is way lighter and I feel like it kind of messed with her foundation a little bit. But I mean, to each his own, you know. This was just a tutorial for YouTube and I'm learning as I go as well. So but yeah, so I always recommend that you go 2 to 3 shades lighter on the under the brows, and that you go 1 shade lighter on top of the brow. So right now it's moving pretty fast, but I'm going in with the Royal Techniques concealer blending brush, and I'm blending in those shadows. I had to go ahead and fix her brow because it didn't have the curve that I want. And now I'm using one of my palettes to go ahead and add in a berry shade, and then I'm cutting her crease and I'm going in with that berry shade again on the end and pulling that shade to the end of the cut crease to make it more seamless. And then I went ahead and added in just a lighter, like a pinkish orangish shade to give it some definition and give it a glow. And yeah, it's moving pretty fast. So I'm basically almost done with her face. I gotta go ahead and contour and set her face. I'm gonna put all of the products that I use, like I said, in the description box, just because I do not remember everything. But for the most part, I use the Morphe palette. I can't remember the name. And then I use My Lashes, Raw Beauty Boutique. And then I know I use Maybelline's Fit Me foundation. So yeah, everything else is gonna be in the description box. Actually, I lied. I used Bare Minerals foundation. So right now, I'm just basically wiping off her lip, the foundation that's on her lips, and going ahead and priming those eyelashes so I can put on those pretty, pretty Raw Beauty Boutique lashes, honey, shop. And then we're going to put some lipstick up on her. giving her basically like a little seductive brown lip. I don't think she really cared for the brown lip. I really liked it personally. I thought it was really, really cute. It came out a little bit more brown than I wanted it to, just because the way that it sweated off of the lipstick. But here is her reaction.
Okay, hold it like this first. Okay, y'all, so, oh, I got turned this way.
Oh, my gosh.
Okay, y'all, so this is our first time getting her makeup done. Hold on, we got to get ghetto real quick. Y'all, this is our first time getting her makeup done. It look cute to me, so go ahead, look at it.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, look, a whole nother person. Oh, my gosh. I look... Ooh. I really am close to like. Do I need more right here?
On the side?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we can put some right there. Do you like it?
My hair. Yeah, I like. I really like the eye part. Let me stop.
It's cute. It looks so good.
I feel like I'm a...
Mess your face up?
Yeah.
Y'all, this is the first time ever getting her makeup done. This is so funny. Literally. It looks so good. Close your eyes. The details. It looks so good. Hold on, we gotta get up close with the light.
I cannot.
It looks so cute. Okay, you go up there. Okay, let me add.
The work of art, he eating his Van Gogh. I am not in the bando. I'm Pablo Sandoz. White beaches, candles. We sexin' and glow. I'm a star, me and Smiley, y'all.